Hello, ladies and gentlemen and newcomers to my channel. My name is Causal Jeffrey, and welcome to my Legend of Zelda I'm so used to saying Majora's Mask that it slips. So, anyway, it is my Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword playthrough. This is episode number 4, and where I last left off, I pretty much found my Loft Wing and went off into a tiddly-turble, topsy-turvy thing, you know, anything. Anyway, so I'm off to find out what that mysterious voice was. So, okay, I have no idea what that's all about, but okay, off we go. Hey, come back! You're from my dreams! Are you the pretty woman who was from my dreams? I must know, because, well, you're really pretty. She disappeared. Okay, then. You're not getting away from me this time! Get this fruit. You're not getting away from me this time! Okay. I didn't even know this was here. Oh, crap. Okay. Well, that was brilliant. Okay. That's how talented I am. Oh. Okay, hi, kitty. What are you doing? Oh my god! What the f- Why, you little piece of crap! You don't ever do that to me! You don't ever do that to me! Okay, I think we're done. Scare crap out of it. Scare them. Crap. Crap out of it. Ooh, what's this? Jelly blob. Okay. Yay, way to bring it into a historical thing. Oh, it's on the left, sorry. Okay, right there. I'd like to be supportive and everything like that, but not in this case. Oh boy, this is gonna be down to the wire. There we go. Not so bad. And I realized there was a treasure chest down there, but damn. Okay, I didn't have to go that overboard, but that's okay. Oh jeez. I'd be scared petrified. Oh, seriously? I can't stab? I mean, I was just going, ha 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 ha, or something like that, and it wasn't doing anything. But that was actually kind of funny, because I didn't know I couldn't do that. Just goes quicker that way. Hmm. Wait, what? Why couldn't I just get in there before? Hmm. Okay. Well. Huh. You know, I just thought of something, that the crest of the Hyrulean bird, I would say, is the Loft Wing, I think. It's not something I thought about up till this point. Leave me alone, you damn bat! And what is this? What is this, I wonder? He's just like, oh my gosh, it's a sword? You already have a sword, Link. You don't need any more. It's the pretty woman. Girl. The one chosen by my creator. I have been waiting for you. You will play a role in a great destiny. According to your social customs, I should provide you with my personal designation. Fee is the name I was given. I was created for the single purpose long before the recorded memory of your people. I must aid you in fulfilling the great destiny that is your burden to carry. Come, Codrival, you must take up this sword. As the one chosen by my creator, it is your destiny. Blunt, don't you think? The strange dreams troubling your sleep, my sudden appearance, uncertainty surrounding the fate of one you hold dear. Under the circumstances, it is only logical that you would exhibit some a word I don't know, but I kind of get the general drift. To minimize your uncertainty, allow me to share some information. My projections indicate that this information has a high probability of altering your current emotional state. What? The one you seek, Honorable Zelda, is still alive. Don't be too surprised. And this spirit maiden, the one you call Zelda, is another chosen one fated to be part of the same great mission. Therefore, should you wish to meet with your friend, I highly recommend you take up this sword before you set out to search for her. You highly recommend? I would say just do it. Does that information invigorate you? Excuse me. Are you ready to accept this sword? I already got a sword on my back. It seems that further persuasive measures will not be required. In the name of my creator, draw the sword and raise it skyward. Oh boy, this should be interesting. If I don't hit the microphone, it's a miracle. I'm gonna walk up ever so slowly. Okay, so I gotta... Alright. I gotta press A. And then I gotta... pull. Just like that. And then up we go. Oh, okay, so I can't twist the hilt. You got the goddess sword. This mysterious sword is bathed in divine light. Okay. It is a beautiful sword, though. Reconfiguration complete, master. Casual. My master. Casual. I had my suspicions, but until now I wasn't sure. Yet here you are in the Chamber of the Sword, the very place where it was foretold the youth of legend would one day appear. Why is it always a foretold? It's a foretold! This is the prophecy, something like that. But whatever. It is said that this place was left to our people by the goddess herself. The very knowledge of this room's existence is a secret passed down to a select few each generation, along with a handful of words. With a handful of words? Like, literal words? Okay. When the light of the goddess's sword shines bright, the great apocalypse will wake from its long slumber. Do not fear, for it is then that a youth guided by my hand shall reveal himself in a place most sacred. It started days ago. The sword that I've kept secret all these years, it begun to give off a faint, overwhelming, or otherworldly light. At first, I was sure I was seeing things. Here alone with the sword, that does not paint a very vague picture, now, doesn't it? There was simply no other explanation. I never dreamed the prophecy of legend would come to pass in my lifetime. You were more like, no, please don't happen, please don't happen. The words I have sworn to keep secret are coming true before my very eyes. The youth will be guided by one born of the blade. One who is also youthful in likeliness, yet wise with knowledge immeasurable. Ah, yes. The oral tradition. One of least reliable methods of information retention and transmission. What? It appears that critical sections of the passage have been lost over the generations. Okay, fill us in, please. I am completely ignorant. The youth who draws forth the guiding sword shall be known as the goddess's chosen hero, and it is he who possesses an unbreakable spirit. He shall be burdened with the task of abolishing the shadow of apocalypse from the land, should his destiny. With the spirit of the blade at his side, he shall soar again, soar over the clouds and plummet below, and unite with the spirit maiden, shall bring forth a piercing light that resurrects the land. That's what I thought it said. Unless I'm mistaken. Some of Father's old texts talk about a place called the surface. The old tales describe a whole land below, far more vast than Skyloft. Excuse me. Flashbacks always leave me just woozy. Anyway, Master, you must embark on a great journey beneath the clouds to the vast realm of the surface. It is only through this journey that you can fulfill the mission set before you by my creator, the goddess. It is also the only method available for you to reunite with the spirit maiden, Honorable Zelda. This is no easy task, Casual. The world below is a forsaken place, and to reach it, you must pierce the cloud barrier below. In living memory, no one has ever done this. Just wait. She's gonna do something fancy-dancy. Okay. And you've been storing that where? This tablet will illuminate a path through the clouds to the land below. Take it and place it within the altar below me. You got the Emerald Tablet. The weathered surface of this heavy stone tablet feels very old. No, really? I would not guessed. Master, the first thing you must do is hit the crest sitting on this room with the Skyward Strike. These blasts are formed of pure energy and energy that charges within your blade when you lift it skyward. Once you have charged your blade, face the crest and swing your sword to send it a powerful skyward strike. Okay. So. Okay, then we're gonna have to go right here. Like that! Okay. So now what? Oh, okay. And that's the magical tune I like to hear. Alright. Examine. I will examine it, indeed. Amazing that it just fits right in there. There's nothing really ambiguous about it. It's like you just put it in right there and you're good. But the funny thing is Link knows where exactly to put it. He knows where to put it. Well, okay then. Master Casual, it is done. Until now, a cloud barrier created by the goddess has separated the world you know from the one below. The tablet you place in the altar has opened a small rift in the barrier. You can use it to travel through the clouds to the realm below. I have recognized you as my master, and so it is my duty to follow you wherever you go. And I realize that's recognized, not resynchronized. Whatever. You're so close. I reside within your sword and will accompany you in your travels. Press down on the D-pad to summon me whenever you require my assistance. Is that your chance to actually go away? Awesome. Casual. Listen a moment. The nature of the Great Apocalypse mentioned in the old text is a complete mystery to me. But whatever it turns out to be, it seems that both you and Zelda have big roles to play in the destiny of this land. Just think, if what this fee says is true, Zelda is alive and no doubt coming to terms with whatever it is the goddess has in store for her. Should we heed the call of destiny? I don't know what dangers you may have to face, Casual, especially down there. But if you've decided to brave the unknown, please find my daughter and bring her back to me. What? What we've seen here today defies explanation. But it is only the start of your journey. Please see through and prove the legend's true. No way! It's too much! Okay! You do your people proud, Casual. That's it? Okay then. Dawn is drawing near. It has been a long night for both of us, hasn't it? You have a great journey before you, Casual. And those clothes, they don't look up to the task. The uniform you were to receive for winning the race should be ready by now. A sturdy uniform like that will prove much more suitable for a long journey. You'd better change before you go. I'm not gonna do that right here, buddy boy. I would love to save it. Gonna pop up every time. Chainmail boots and clothing underneath. He is gonna sweat like a pig. Oh, and he even has gauntlets. Wonderful. That green uniform is what our knights will be wearing this year. To be honest, I've had my doubts about the color. But oddly enough, seeing you wear this uniform, I can imagine a more fitting color for you. It's as though you were born to wear it. You think? That is Link's color, period, even if his eyes are blue. It does not matter. It is the hero's color. Take care on your journey, and be sure to stop by some of the shops at the Bazaar, or whatever it's called, here in town to equip yourself properly for the travels ahead. I will return to my quarters and see if I can glean more useful information on the ancient texts. You are always welcome to stay by if you have questions. You and Zelda shall be in my prayers. May the goddess watch over and guide you both. Okay, finally, the context is over. I'm just gonna head out. Thank you. If I have to talk to anyone else, I'm just gonna plow right through them. Wonderful. Casual. That green uniform looks so adventurous. You sure look like a knight now. The headmaster said you're heading out to look for Zelda. You're really something else. I could never imagine myself doing what you're about to do. I put a lot of work into making this. You should take it with you. And it would be... an adventurer pouch. It allows me to just store stuff. Like that. It's an adventurer pouch. It's for adventures, obviously. It's neat because you can fit four things in it that you need on your big journey. You can buy all kinds of stuff at the Bazaar, whatever it's called, that you can put in this pouch. You should go look. You should buy some potions and a shield. They'd fit in your pouch. They might come in handy on an adventure. Casual, I just know you'll find Zelda for us. Thank you. Now leave me alone. Oh, you, it's another Dorcas. Hi.
Hey.
Wait, you just saw the news? Okay. Out of all of us, how come only you got promoted to a senior class? Talk about stupid calls. On top of that, Groose won't come out of his room, and Zelda is missing. It's all your fault. Way to go there, buddy. Some senior class guy you are. What a dork. You're no better than Groose. I'm actually kind of curious. Is there... Nope. Okay. Good. I can get the hell out of here. Alright. If there's anybody else to talk to, please. I'm going to shuffle right through them. Oh, great. Oh, well, I'm just going to leave that alone for now. So I'm going to end the video right here. So I will just simply say thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to leave me a like, it lets me know how I'm doing. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on a second. I just realized I haven't told you what I'm going to do in the next episode. In the next episode, I'm just going to start my adventure right there. So I think that I will leave it right there. So anyway, as I left off, if you want to leave a comment in the comment section, that will also let me know how I'm doing. If you want to leave an, I will leave a link in... okay. I'm lost, so I will leave an ending card so that way you guys can watch more. That way you can watch the last episode, so that way if you haven't seen the one before that, you can do that. And I will leave a link in the description for my channel, so that way if you want to see what my channel is all about, or what other videos I want to do, or I do, then you can do that also. And if you want to leave a if you want to share this video, that will actually help me support the channel. So thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I will see you guys next time. Let's go!